Siren Head. Doesn't it sound like a rock band from like the 80s or something?
It really does.
Yeah.
It actually does.
Yes, it certainly does, but it definitely is not a band or anything remotely close to that.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I have a special guest with me today.
What's going on, guys? My name is Joss Bedard, and I am actually on our sister channel called Top 10 Central. If you're looking for a laugh, please come check us out. And Lindsay and I did a collab video on that channel called Top 10 Funniest Before and After Pictures, so make sure you come and check it out.
Please
it's really
do.
Funny.
It is, yeah.
But I say we just get right into it. Here is the Top 10 Scary Siren Head Facts.
Let's get on into it.
Kicking off this countdown at number 10 is, where did Siren Head come from? This will all depend on what your beliefs are. Some will believe that an artist named Trevor Henderson created the towering monster back in 2018, while others will believe that he's been around since the 1960s. The artist first shared an image of Siren Head on his Twitter in 2018 and had a very creepy response, with people coming forward with sighting stories. However, the 40-foot tall creature was reported to be seen for the first time back in 1966, when a family on a vacation in the Arizona desert captured a photo of him. Turns out the family was doing some typical tourist stuff and explored the desert, which led them to an old cemetery. Like most people would, they snapped a picture of it, but when they developed the pictures later on, they saw the monster just standing there in between some gravestones. Like, that is some scary movie content right there. That is a family vacation you will never forget.
Moving on to number 9. Siren Head has multiple ways to manipulate its victims. In fact, he is known as the embodiment of fear, anxiety, and war. When he is close to his victim, he can make them feel immense pain with these fears. He uses this to his advantage to disorient his prey and even make them walk straight to him. Also, it is said that the closer you get to Siren Head, then the faster your heart will beat. So if you're out wandering about and you start getting heart palpitations, no, it's not from drinking too much coffee. It may just be because Siren Head is lurking a little too close to you.
Sliding to the number 8 spot is the scary fact that he will kidnap you. Not only do I not want to be like kidnapped in general, but the last thing I want kidnapping me is this 40-foot double-headed radio like man creature. Like, if I'm gonna get kidnapped, at least give me a chance to escape. Equal playing field kind of thing. But there are some victims who got snatched up by him and lived on to tell the tale. One of them's name is Chad. He shared his story online, saying that on July 16th, 1995, he and his friends were hiking in the woods of Tanyard Creek, where they spotted him just lurking around. According to Chad, his friends got snatched up by the creature, which started using his siren heads to mimic their voices as part of a way to throw off any kind of rescue plan. The only good part of the story is that Chad was actually found alive with just a few minor injuries, but his friends were never found. After this story came to surface, other people claim that Siren Head was spotted in Indiana and citizens just started disappearing without any explanation. Coincidence? I think not.
Moving on to number 7, Siren Head doesn't even have a brain, yet he's capable of doing complex tasks and is quite intelligent. Someone tell me how this creature is capable of having strong cognitive abilities but is brainless. Like, I can barely remember what I had for breakfast, and yet this creature is out there without a brain but still practically gifted. It was cereal though. I had cereal for breakfast. So, Siren Head can execute elaborate plans and is the master at manipulation and can think and process information quickly. Seriously, this creature just keeps becoming more and more terrifying. What's next? He has like flamethrower arms? I don't know.
All right, guys, we are at number 6 now, and you're probably wondering what the sirens on his head do. Like, what is their purpose? Clearly, they aren't blasting out music or helpful public service announcements, so what is the deal? The two sirens on his head give him the ability to release sounds of many different things. The typical sound of a siren, screams, static, and also human conversations. I can only imagine how awful that would be to have like screams or TV static playing that loud from a 40-foot monster. Talk about making my ears bleed. But that is not the worst part. One special power these sirens give him is the power of mimicking. He can actually mimic the voices of other humans and play it out loud, which helps him out with his kill. When he attacks a group of people, he can use their voices to distract them or lead them a different way. Maybe you thought the sirens were just like a silly look. I personally underestimated them.
We are now at our halfway mark with number 5. Now, let's talk about his eerie appearance. He may just appear to be a tall, rusty looking creature, but in fact, he is composed of dried, mummified skin. Siren Head also appears very malnourished and gaunt looking, and he will always maintain this appearance even after feasting on multiple victims. Dang, he must have like a super fast metabolism then. Now, the only part of his body that is made of metal is parts of the speakers that are fused in with his skin. He has the speaker wires running down his neck and body, which can be seen also pressed into his skin. In fact, when this creature is angry, it is said that the wires will begin twitching. Now, that's not all. His arms are said to be the same length of his body, making it easy for him to pick up his prey. He can also rotate his head around his body like an owl so he can target his victims. This dude is the definition of creepy.
I am bringing some bad news for number four, you guys. Siren Head is not the only monster. There's actually another monster which was actually introduced by the same artist, Trevor Henderson, called the Long Horse. When I hear that name, I think, what could possibly be so scary about like a long looking horse? But then I saw a picture of it and I regretted ever asking that. Let me describe him to you a little bit so you get a better idea. His skin isn't like a regular horse, it's actually wax, which allows his neck and body to bend just like a human finger would. Like Siren Head, he too has special abilities. He can make new joints for himself on demand. So if you thought of just like hacking him into pieces as a defense mechanism, you probably need to rethink a good plan. The scariest part is that despite his size, he's deathly quiet, so you won't actually hear him coming. One bright side to this deadly monster is that he smells like cinnamon. I don't know how, I don't understand why, but the next time you smell cinnamon, check out your surroundings.
At number three, let's talk about his diet. Now, Siren Head apparently only likes to eat two things. One of them being humans. Sorry everyone. And the other being a creature named Bloodlusts. Now, Bloodlusts are other skinny creatures, but they do not have arms, ears, noses, or mouths. But they do have eyes on their forehead that act as their mouths. Does not sound appetizing to me. On top of that, these creatures are also super powerful. But Siren Head is more dominant and can kill and eat them easily. In fact, in order to capture the bloodless creatures, Siren Head can remain motionless for multiple days. This allows them to attract multiple bloodless and then feast on them all at one time. However, humans are still their preferred meal, so watch out.
We're moving on to number two. Guess what? There is more than one Siren Head. What makes this fact so terrifying is the only reason we know this is because there has been multiple sightings across the globe. And although he has incredibly long legs, there is no way that he could be walking around traveling this much. Many sightings have been reported, and apparently they like to change their location only if their hunting doesn't go to plan. Siren Heads spend most of their time on the prey, searching for humans to stalk and then kill. So if there are no humans in the area, they will often just relocate. But they aren't always on the move. They can actually remain motionless, like Lindsay mentioned, for days at a time. But why would they want to do that? In fact, it is in fear of each other. A Siren Head knows that a human cannot defeat him, but multiple creatures of his kind could easily team up and take over his hunting grounds. I mean, as long as they don't like relocate to Canada, I'm good. And you're good too. We're safe.
Yay, we're safe. And coming in at our number one spot, Siren Head has multiple powers or abilities. The first being to mimic, as Jocelyn mentioned before. The second being strength. Siren Head creatures are super strong. They can break down trees, throw boulders, or move other objects with ease. On top of that, they are super fast as well. So if it's a one-on-one between you and Siren Head, there's no point in even trying. You can't outrun him or even outsmart him. And he is also the master at stealth. He can blend in seamlessly with the surrounding forest, so you won't even see him coming. And lastly, he may even be a shapeshifter. It is said that he may be able to transform his head into street lamp lights or other forms of sirens, but that is still not confirmed. And I wouldn't want confirmation either. You won't find me anywhere near this creature. All right, that's all the facts that we have on Siren Head for you today. Let's move on to our comment section and shout out some comments from my video, Top 10 Urban Explorers Who Went Missing.
Baby Bunny Bull 17 said, I love this one, my fave. I'ma just say, give me a shout out. I love you guys.
There you go.
There you go. That is your shout out. You put a lot of effort into that, so you earned it.
Laurel Wells, Georgia commented, I've always wanted to explore the Paris catacombs, but this is too scary. I agree, the Paris catacombs, they look kind of cool, but
Would you do it?
I don't know.
I feel like I would.
I kind of do want
to. Like you want to. Like once in a lifetime you want to, but I'd be so scared.
But like if I get lost, then I'm...
Yeah, you're screwed.
You're screwed.
The Gaming Cheetah commented saying, hi,
how you doing? We're good.
Or maybe it's how you doing.
I hope you're saying like, hey, how you doing?
Yeah,
how you doing?
And lastly, Karma's commented, if you have a great joke for me, please, I want to laugh. I mean,
do I have a joke? Oh my god.
What did the llama say when it got kicked off the farm?
What?
I'll pack up my bags.
Oh my god.
It's so bad. It's
alpaca?
I'll pack up my bags.
Alright guys, that is all for today. As always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10. Also, head on over to Top 10 Central to see the video that we made together. And you can also find Eamon there. She is also on the channel with me. It's a lot of fun.
It is. See you guys later.
See ya.
Bye.